Hello, my name is Lauri Lovén and I'm postdoctoral researcher at the Center for Ubiquitous Computing. My talk today is about intelligence in the computing continuum. So if we look at the history of computing, it is a history of ebb and flow of centralization and decentralization. So first we had the mainframes, large computational units which were centralized. Then we had the PCs. Suddenly everybody had computational capacity at their own desktops. And this was, of course, decentralization of computation. Moving on, those PCs were networked. And then we found out that actually we need cloud-based computing centers, which can provide ample computational capacity for the PCs and for the local computational units, support them with heavy computational capacity and heavy computational computing storage capacity. And now again, we have noticed that the cloud computing is not sufficient. We again need to decentralize, coming back from the centralized computing centers again to decentralized distributed computing. So why do we do that then? We have a number of use cases which require distributed computing. For example, industrial use cases of Industry X.0, Industry 4.0, where production lines in factories might create huge amounts of data with sensors, and then this sensor data needs to be analyzed and then used for controlling those production lines. Or we have medical data, or we have autonomous operations, massive autonomous operations, or traffic-related use cases, where the common factor is that there is either huge amounts of data being generated locally, there is a need for low latency, or a requirement for high privacy. So all of this calls for edge fog computing, where computing capacity is brought back from the cloud to close to where data is generated. So there are two perspectives to edge computing. One is the cloud-centric perspective, where at the center of everything is the cloud. So all of the heavy lifting and intelligence resides in the cloud, and then parts of it is lifted to the edge to computational capacity that is nearby, close to the users, close to where data is being generated. Or there is the internet-centric perspective, where edge is actually the edge of the internet. So internet is at the center, and now we notice that actually clouds, as well as the local computational environments, are both at the edge. So taking a closer look at these two perspectives, first the cloud-centric perspective, we can find the assumptions behind this perspective. Cloud provides the core services. Edge provides local proxies for the cloud for offloading some parts of the cloud's workload. And then cloud is responsible for the heavy lifting. And edge is in a supporting role here. And the problem here is that actually this doesn't take into account that usually the edge computing devices are capable and should be capable of independent operation even without the cloud. So let's say connection from the factory floor is severed to the cloud, the control systems at the factory should still be operational. Taking a look at the internet-centric perspective, then we have the assumptions that internet is the center and not the cloud. And here the edge devices function as gateways to the internet. And the local networks are organized around the edge devices, which act as gateways to the internet. So the things, the devices in the local networks are not really dependent on the cloud, but they are more dependent on the edge devices providing access and providing extra capacity. And if we take this perspective, we come into a number of revelations. For example, cloud is also one kind of an edge. And these things really belong to their local networks, not any system that is centered around one of the clouds. there shouldn't be a need to communicate with the cloud or rely on the cloud. And finally, the edge nodes really may be disconnected from the internet, so they need to be able to function autonomously. Now, moving on towards AI. So this is the computing environment and the use cases that we are looking at. And then bringing intelligence into this environment. We know that by AI, we mean things and systems that are smart. They are capable of acting as if a human were making decisions. They are capable of learning from their experience, and they are capable of autonomous action. So herein we come into a sort of a conflict, because edge is built on opportunistic and distributed resources, meaning that devices and resources can appear and disappear at will, and they are distributed geographically. Connectivity may be breaking, it might be intermittent or fluctuating. And devices and platforms are really heterogeneous. So some devices might have really low computational capacity, while some might have a lot computational capacity. And the platforms also running on top of these devices might be very different from each other. And of course, there's the geospatial distribution behind everything. So we might have multiple sites, all with the local networks, which are far from each other. However, if we look at AI solutions, traditional or current AI solutions, they are mostly relying on pooled data and centralized processing. And they are often very computationally extremely demanding. And they rely on a homogeneous and stable run environment. So if we look at, for example, GPT-3, we know that it had about 175 billion parameters. And GPT-4, which is currently available, has maybe 10 times, maybe 100 times more parameters. So these are huge models requiring huge computational capacity for training as well as inference. So we have these two sides. On the other side, the edge environment provides opportunistic distributed resources, intermittent connectivity, heterogeneous devices and platforms, and this is heavily geospatially distributed. And the AI methods that are centralized, computationally demanding and requiring homogeneous run environments. So we need to somehow bring these together. And on one side of this, we have AI on edge, where we transform the or modify or devise new ways, new methods for artificial intelligence, which are capable of surviving in the edge environment. So moving away from centralized systems, centralized models, computationally demanding models and homogeneous run environments. So we have the centralized, current centralized models and methods for AI. We need to move into decentralized and distributed training and inference. Computationally demanding models, we need to be able to adapt to changing computational requirements and environments. And moving away from homogeneous environments into models and methods that support heterogeneous and opportunistic environments. Then the other side of the coin is AI for edge, where we use these modified AI methods for surviving and for helping the edge environment to run smoothly. So here we use predictive and prescriptive analytics, optimization, localized intelligence, and autonomous systems for orchestrating or managing the edge environment, optimizing its resources and optimizing its resource usage. So here, this is called edge orchestration. And now we arrive at the main topic of my talk here. So edge orchestration means the smooth management of applications that are running in the edge cloud, device edge cloud continuum, computing continuum. Here is an example of a possible two possible applications running in the computing continuum, and depicted are a number of computational and communicational resources, access points, edge nodes, sensors and actuators, which are located somewhere, let's say, in a smart city environment. On top of these devices and computing nodes, we have middleware resources which allow us to run application components such as microservices and serverless functions. And based on these application components, we have a number of tasks and data flows between these tasks. So for example, on the left side, we have data being lifted from a video camera and a sensor arriving at some microservices and then being transferred and analyzed throughout a series of different microservices, throughout a series of tasks running on these microservices, and finally ending up on an actuator, which is then perhaps opening a door or changing the temperature or controlling production line or controlling ventilation in a smart building. So we have hardware and cyberphysical resources, we have middleware resources, we have application components and resources, we have application workflow related resources, and optimization of this multi-layered complex system of systems is the edge orchestration. And edge orchestration comprises a number of different functions, such as monitoring, data flow management, discovery of services and resources, allocation of resources, lifecycle management of resources, to meet objectives related to cost, quality and resources set by a number of different stakeholders in the computing continuum, such as, for example, end users, application providers, platform providers, and infrastructure providers. And all of this can be done in a number of different ways, for example, in relation to security and privacy and fault tolerance or control topology. These functions could be centrally controlled, for example, or they could be distributed or decentralized in control. And implementing these functions in a way that fits the edge cloud continuum or fits the edge environment, that's the big challenge here. So how to do it then? We again come back to the AI methods. So we need to find the right AI methods for deciding on when and how to implement those functions. This is coming back into adapting the AI methods that are currently available. So there is a feedback loop here. We need to build new AI methods to be able to cope in the edge environment so that we can modify and adapt and manage the edge environment, which again changes the AI methods that are capable of surviving there. And this is a very interesting and fruitful kind of feedback loop that we are seeing here. So some recent examples of what this can actually mean in practice. For example, we might have a citywide sensor network of mobile sensors which are connected to edge nodes by way of 5G or 6G communication, and we need to manage and orchestrate the data flows between these sensors and the edge nodes to be able to optimally learn some models that describe the environment, for example. Or we might be looking into a number of access points spread around the city. Here we can see the Pan-Oulu Wi-Fi, public Wi-Fi network access points, a few hundred of them spread around the city of Oulu, with some of those access points more popular than others. The yellow ones, or the brighter the color, the more traffic those access points experience. And here the question is, if we have a limited number of computational capacity to place in this environment, to place next to certain access points, where should we put those when we consider the traffic on those access points, the need for computational capacity? So turns out that this is a problem that can be modeled as a clustering problem, and then you need to devise new ways of performing that clustering that take into consideration, for example, the resulting latency from end devices to those edge nodes, or also a balanced capacity for the edge nodes. So these are kind of conflicting requirements. You need to have a method that is able to kind of accommodate both of these. So here are some recent references from the last couple of years on this topic. And that concludes my presentation for today. Thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me. You can see the email on the screen. Thank you.